Yeah, I know what you're thinking. You can get a job in the Middle East simply by trying or by magic through others or by fluke. Remember that competition is everywhere. Some here, some there, but bam, Loy Macedo is the best.
Oh. Wait, let me put on my new watch. I bought this new watch. So what's this watch? Okay, before I share my video, I'll do this video. This new watch, why? Let's put the topic, why did I buy a new watch after all these years? You know, I have not had a watch for, I never understood the function of having a watch. I never found it necessary, especially when there was the smartphone. So, right from the beginning, I decided, okay, I'll not wear a watch. Especially when I used to see people wearing a watch to show off. You know, you would wear an expensive watch like a Rolex or Seiko or some high-end watch and show the diamond encrusted or gold or titanium or whatever, silver. So I was like, okay, I'll not wear a watch. I don't want to show off. I don't know, I just decided. And ever since I never wore a watch, I used to see people wearing a watch and having a smartphone. But eventually, I guess, people realized, especially the new generation, that you don't need a watch. You have a smart device, tells you everything. However, there were some old timers who would still wear a watch. And then Apple came out with the Apple Watch, and I was like, why the fuck would you need a watch? You already have a device in your hand. Why the hell do you need one more? So I tried to see the features. On the Apple Watch, there was nothing but these tiny, small little widgets. As it is, I can't see small stuff nowadays. Getting old, you know. And then you're like, what the fuck is that? And, you know, and on top of that, you have to scroll. And who wants all this drama? People are just buying watch, just sheep mentality, you know. And then when I wore the watch, just to see what it was, I started to feel it vibrate, and I was like, why is it vibrating? So the guy told me, oh, notifications. And I, that's stupid, man. I just imagine you get 1,000 notifications, and 1,000 times it keeps vibrating. What the fuck? As it is, you have enough and more distractions in your day-to-day life. Then you have the internet distraction. Then you have a smartphone distraction. Now you need a watch-based distraction. For what? I did see many people wearing the watch to make a fashion statement, but then I was like, this is stupid. However, when I started training for the for marathon running, half marathon, initially I was just going with the flow. But later on, when I got myself a proper coach, expensive guy, he told me, Loy, I want you to buy a watch. So, like an idiot, I didn't even ask him which one, whatever. He told me, you know, for running and all that. So I ended up buying a Garmin, I think a Garmin 220. And I was using it for some time. He told me for running and, you know. But very soon, I moved into getting into triathlon, that is swimming and cycling. So running, swimming, cycling. So then I realized my this watch was not good, you know, for all three sports. So he told me, buy Polar, P-O-L-A-R. So I said, okay, why? He said, the Polar watch is good for swimming, cycling, and running, and it's used by triathletes. And then along with that, he also recommended me to buy a heart rate monitor, which I never used. So it was fancy at that time, so I ended up buying that. And believe it or not, it made a big difference, huh? It made a big difference to my performance. I was able to calculate how fast I ran, my heart rate. I knew what range I had to keep my heart rate in. This is something that you'll only learn when you're with a coach. So I knew what was my heart rate, what range I had to keep it based on my, you know, age and weight, and then how many hours I was training, what is the distance I was running. So it was pretty good. And then I would have speed sessions. I'd have sessions where I ran 50% of my capacity, 70%. Then I knew how much I could push for 80 to 90%. So this went on for some time. And then obviously when I left UAE, I stopped using that watch. I use the watch only while doing sports, not otherwise. Finally now, you know, I like to live a simple life. I didn't want a watch. But because I do these runs every day, you know, it's mentally a little hard to know how many laps I'm doing. Sometimes, you know, I do normally 6 laps, but then I forget when I'm running, okay, did I do the 4th lap or 3rd lap or is it the 5th lap? So confusing, you know. But I always do one more just to be on the safe side. So finally I was like, man, this is crazy. And I didn't even know what distance I was running. I didn't even know what pace I was running. So finally I was like, okay, I even go for a walk. People have asked me like, Loy, how much do you walk per day or how much do you run? I used to give them vague answers like, okay, 4 kilometers, 3 kilometers. So I didn't have it specific. So finally I decided, okay, need to buy a watch. I had it back of my head. And one fine day I found this Garmin going on a special offer. It's a Garmin 245, that is without music. So it was going for, I think $50 or $30, something in that range. Not too expensive, man. What am I saying? 7,000, that's roughly around $200, yeah. So it was going on a special offer or something like that. I said, okay, I'll pick it up. So today I used it. After this video, I'll put the exact distance of how much I ran today and how much I walked while making, you know, multiple videos. I generally run for 30 minutes and I walk for 20 minutes to 1 hour while making videos. So in answer to why did I buy this watch, you know, this one, why did I buy it? Look. Why did I buy the watch? It's because one is to check how much exercise am I doing. It has a heart rate monitor to monitor my heart levels, especially after my surgery. To know how much sleep I'm getting, because, you know, my sleep is always off whack, man. And then, you know, how much distance exercise I'm doing and how many hours. General, just to give a screenshot information per week. So I kind of have an idea and I know whether I want to increase, decrease. Because remember, when you have numbers, it's always good, you know. When you have data, if you just say, I did exercise means what? But if you have specific data, it adds value, you know. And you can use that data to, you know, improve your performance and get better. So yeah, that's why I bought this watch. So let me know, do you use a watch? You know, which is the watch that you're using? What do you recommend? Do you use a heart rate monitor? You know, stuff like that. Love to hear from you guys. And it's always good to exchange information. So anyway, you guys take care. Thanks for sharing. And mind you, there are some really not so expensive brands that are cheap brands as well. So I think my wife got one for free from Galaxy or something. So there are some cheaper alternatives that give you the same, you know, benefits. So let me know, which brand do you have? What do you recommend? What are the features you use? It's great to hear from you guys. All right, you guys take care.